First, the year of faith, then the year of mercy. Now the Catholic Biblical Federation has proposed the idea of the year of the Bible to the Vatican for the 2019-2020 year. However, they were given a negative response.
We received a letter from Archbishop Fisichella saying that with these changes now in the Curia, the strategies, the plans, they decided to do no more these specific years, because there were some complaints also from the bishops that it was an obstacle in the regular pastoral plans in the diocese, so there will be no more years convoked by the Vatican.
Despite this note, the Federation says they still plan to have a Jubilee year of their own, since 2019 marks the 50th anniversary of the CBF, and 2020 is the 1,600th anniversarial death of Saint Jerome, who was the first translator of the Bible to Latin. The members, with Cardinal Tagle as president, will also host a large pastoral congress in Rome the week after Easter 2019 to reflect on the past 50 years and see where they're going in the next.
Biblically, every jubilee is a time of liberation. It's a time that gives life once more. And so to celebrate the 50th year of the foundation of the Federation is already a jubilee. And so we are going to blow the shofar to invite everyone. And we see that great enthusiasm in people, especially, you know, realizing the importance of what is going to be done and what they've been involved in and the history behind this and how connected it is with the faith. This is what we stand for.
Connected to the Holy See through the Pontifical Council for Christian Unity, the Catholic Biblical Federation is represented in 126 countries. Based on the need of each country, they organize everything from translations to publications, formation and pastoral activities centered around the Word of God.
Pope Francis participated in the International Biblical Pastoral Congress. It was organized to mark the 50th anniversary of the Catholic Biblical Federation. This organization promotes the translation and dissemination of the Bible, study of sacred scripture, pastoral ministry, and interfaith dialogue.
Santo Padre.
Holy Father, on behalf of the 200 participants in the International Biblical Congress from 68 countries, I would like to thank you for this meeting. The Pope thanked them for their work. He told them to make sure the Bible does not remain in libraries, but is spread across the world to people.
Tante parole affluiscono quotidianamente alle nostre orecchie, trasmettendo informazioni e dando molteplici input. Tante forse troppe, al punto di superare spesso la nostra capacità di accogliere. Ma non possiamo rinunciare alla parola di Gesù, all'unica parola di vita eterna, di cui abbiamo bisogno ogni giorno.
Pope Francis asked priests to reflect on the Bible for their homilies. This is so they may speak the Word of God and not be self-referential. He added the biblical scriptures are like fire and wind. The Bible has a creativity able to widen the horizons for believers.